Hi everybody, this is Byron Jacobs for EverymanChess.com. Today I'm going to be making a short video about a new book that we have in our Move by Move series. It's a book on the Torre Attack by international master Richard Palliser. If you want to know what the generic idea of the Move by Move series is, there's another video up here that explains that in some detail, so I won't cover that here. I'll just talk specifically about this book. As you will probably know, the Torre Attack relies on the move Bishop g5 as white in the queen's pawn openings. A typical example being as follows: white opens d4, black develops the knight, and then white develops the knight, and then the idea is, against more or less any third move from black, he's going to continue with the move Bishop g5. He will also play this move against g6 or indeed d5. It's a slightly less theoretically demanding opening than a lot of the other ways of playing 1d4, and as such is ideal for club and tournament players who want a good weapon to use as 1d4 when playing 1d4 without having to get bogged down in loads of theory. It also works very well in the move-by-move format because it relies much more on understanding of positions and ideas rather than memorising reams and reams of specific moves in specific variations. The author, Richard Palliser, is a highly respected author who's written a substantial number of chess books for EverymanChess.com, all of which have received great critical and public acclaim. Now, on the site you can see extracts from the book which show which variations it covers and also shows the introduction, so I'm not going to go over that material in here. Instead, in this short video, I'm going to try and convince you of one simple fact. Many people have the impression that the Torre Attack is a slightly dull way to play as white, and that it's just a mechanism to sort of grind people down or just head for a draw or something like that. But actually, there are some very, very dynamic possibilities for white, and I'm going to show you one game here very quickly, or one extract from a game which I hope will convince you of that and lead you to believe that the Torre Attack can be handled in a very strong, aggressive and dynamic fashion. The game I have in mind starts off with the following sequence. You've already seen the first three moves here. Black blocks the potential pin with the move Bishop e7, and white develops in characteristic style with the bishop on d3, the knight coming to d2, and here white plays the move c3 rather than castling. And the point is that he actually wants to leave his king in the centre because he has some ambitious ideas. His plan is that after black plays the natural developing move knight c6, white continues with knight e5, and after knight takes knight, pawn takes knight, knight d7, a very natural sequence, we reach an interesting position about which Richard poses a question in the book. White has a very natural sequence here by capturing on e7 and continuing with f4. But instead, Richard wants you to stop and think about if you can find a more interesting, aggressive way for white to handle this position. Now, if I flick back to the board, the problem with white continuing with the sequence bishop takes e7, queen takes e7, f4, which looks promising at first sight, is that black then breaks up the white centre with f6, and by doing this obtains a good game. So white needs to find another way to proceed after the black knight retreat to d7, which is this position. And what Richard shows in the book is that white can do better with the move bishop f4, retreating the bishop, holding on to the pawn on e5 and lining himself up for a kingside attack. We'll now flick back to the board and see this in action. So here white continues with bishop f4 instead of the capture on e7. And now black plays f5 in an attempt to blunt the white attack that's coming quickly on the king side with a move such as queen h5. However, now white can really get going on the king side as he has a target with the move g4. And now black has a response plan to this with g5, which looks loosening, but the idea is he wants to push the bishop back and possibly continue with f4, winning a piece, but white sacrifices the piece to open up some lines against the king as follows, and now continues his attack with the Greek gift bishop sacrifice, bringing his queen into the game and recapturing the knight on e5. This is a difficult position for black, where he should play the move bishop f6, but in the game he actually played rook f6, and after rook check, king f8, queen h5, there was no defence against the white attack. So, I hope that's convinced you that the Torre attack can lead to some very dashing attacking play, and that you'll be very keen to rush out and buy this book and see all the different ways that you can whip up a quick kingside attack and mate your unsuspecting opponent. We're very pleased with this book and we're sure you're going to like it. The Torre Attack, Move by Move by Richard Palliser, is available in Europe and the UK in May 2012 and will be available in the US in July 2012. This has been Byron Jacobs for EverymanChess.com. Thank you for listening.